I see all the manifestation, million people in the street protesting against Trump and everything, but these are all people who fall into the trap. This is Sheikh Caleb, right here in Church One. When you think about something that bothering you, like it's a setup, and it's clear that it's something that you don't gonna like. But it's a setup, you know. So the thing you need to do, it's not think about it. Don't fall into the trap. It's a trap. It's clear. It's right down on the sky that it's a trap. Like, if you think about it, you fall into the trap. So, be the observer. Be the observer. That's the only thing you need to do. It's to observe. Okay, yes, it is. It's that. But don't let your mind, your ego mind, to complain about it. Don't go into that environment. You don't want to go there. What you want to do is go into your heart, huh? Stay into your heart and just say, I know. I know it's like that. But I'm focused on me, on what I am doing, not on the setup. Don't focus on the problem. You know it's a problem, but don't fall for it. Because when you fall for it, when you think about it, when you complain and you start to, oh, why this happened, and then you call everybody, you know, and you make that, it's, you participate in the problem. And first of all, the people who set up the problem, they only play their part of, do you gonna fall into the trap, or you gonna pass the test? Because remember, we are in the school of life. And do you gonna fail, or do you gonna pass? So if you react to it, not only verbally, but mentally, if you fall into the trap, why this happened? Fuck! And you start to go in that road. You participate into the problem. And the people who make the setup, it's unconscious. It's not on purpose. They don't know what they just done. But one thing for sure is that you need to know that you need to not fall for it. You are strong enough to be the better person. Be the light. You see dark. Don't let your mind spin into bad, because you participate into the bad, and bad plus bad lead to more bad. Next week is gonna get worse, and the week after worse. But if you don't think about it and you stay focused on you, on your goal, your divine life mission purpose, your action, what you do, be present, focus on the now. Focus on the light that you are. Focus on paradigm zero. And you will see that these little tests from the old world will disappear, because you don't fuel them with your thought. Oh, don't fuel The test of thought. Don't fuel these tests. It's for you to think about it, to react to it. What you can do is grab your phone and do exactly what I do now. You can explain and learn from what you observe and share it with the people. Because it's okay to warn them that this is what takes place right now. And since we are all connected, this is good for everybody. You see something bad, why you see something bad? Don't fall for it. Depends what it is. You can have compassion, but don't make a case out of it. You know, okay, if you are a detective, if you are a detective, I don't know, sounds weird. Yes, you can do your job. Yeah, do your job, you know. Me, I'm a cleaner. Here is what I do. And it's my mission to transform this dirty church into the most clean church on the planet. But I got two, so the two cleanest church in the world. Anyway, and I know this because the ego us, will see something and gonna react to it right away. Mentally first, in the head, and after you're gonna start to react and you're gonna feel it in your body, and that's not a good feeling. That's a no-no. And that's what I realized, and I need to share that with you. I never hear somebody say that, what I just say now. But it's all a part of the school of life. But where we are going, when we apply paradigm zero, it's only love. There is no bad. There is no test of bad. There is only good. And that's the reality. But there is a transition to there. It's like you go from a school to a university. Yeah, that's cool. I like that. Yeah. So you need to get exam and everything. So you need to deal with it. And some of the tests, what I notice is that if you pay attention to it mentally first, you fail the test. It's gonna come back right away, first thought. But you can't stop that by reclaiming back your power and be present and know why you are here and what you do. Don't let this distraction stop you, because it's gonna grab all your power like a vortex, and you don't want that. You wanna be fluid. You wanna create your own flow into the flow of life. And when you stay in your heart and you can see this happen in front of you, you know it's a good sign. Hey, little test, huh? You see little negativity test, you don't react to it, you know it's there, but you keep doing what you do best and you don't think about it. It's like it's not important. It's not important. And you pass the test. You stay focused on you, on be present. How grateful you are to be here and healthy and be able to create magic with what you got the best to offer. So that's the tip of the day, I like to say that. And we're gonna remember this. And you're gonna remember too. Because why there is so many problems on earth? It's because people fall into the trap and they fall for it. So they fuel. Every time they fall for the trap, they fuel the trap. And the trap becomes more, and it becomes a global trap. And what the direction where we go now is that the old world dies and the new world rise. And it all starts with paradigm zero. Apply it, start right now, get the information, listen to the video that I'm gonna make, because it is in process right now. But I'm gonna release this video at the same time than paradigm zero. So it's gonna be relate both of them. So that's it. I'm gonna do what I have to do, and I say what I have to say with my full authenticity, with my heart into the driver's seat of my body. Oh yeah, left hand on my heart, I can see light. Peace. What I understand is that the heart focuses always on what is good, never on what is bad. So if you're in your heart, you're never gonna go do a manifestation. Manifestation, it's falling into the trap. Yes, we have a liberty of choice, but wait a minute, okay? What kind of choice we're talking about here? The choice good and bad? We live in a yin-yang world, okay? Yes. But you are not yin-yang. Yes, yes. You need to be balanced. So, there is a part of you that you need to balance. Huh? But you are not good or bad. The illusion is that you think that you have this choice. And they want you to think that. And we grow up in it. So the thing is that we need to break out of it. And I realized that for me, since I'm a cleaner, the trap, it's to complain about how dirty it is, for real. But it's the hardest thing to do, because if I am the best cleaner in the world, my expectation is that it's become less and less dirty, because I do such an amazing job. But we live in a yin-yang world. It's the reality, it's the fact. If I see otherwise, I lie to myself. And that's what we do on planet Earth. We lie to ourselves. We know the truth, but we lie. So we need to stop lying about the reality. So the reality is, for like, take example, it's really fucking dirty. I need to not react to it. I do my mission, I do my purpose, I do it without complaining. I stay focused on what is truly matter. Stay in my heart, stay focused, be disciplined, and go through it. How dirty it is, it doesn't matter, because I still need to do it. And the effect by not reacting to it, because dirty, it's negative, okay? It's bad. It's not yoo-hoo. It's oh shit, no. Okay? And that's the reality. So my mission is to raise up the energy when the energy is oh no. Okay? So I need to focus on do my thing, you know, my magic thing that I do, but stay out of my head of how dirty it is, because there is the trap. Okay, now let's get back. I need to talk about Trump. Okay, Trump, he do all these massive change that nobody have the guts to do, and of course it's gonna trigger a whole lot of people. The worst thing you can do is react to it. It's falling into the trap. It's participating into the problem. Because remember one thing, him is just only playing his part. He do his mission. See, that's it. So if you fuel, it's gonna get worse. So stop doing manifestation, stop talking about it, stop looking at it, you know, let him do his thing and you create your own reality, create your own thing, do your own thing, share your own content. If everybody share his own news, positive news, all this will disappear just like that. Because what is truly real on earth, it's love. We were born made of love, huh? When two people make love together and they decide to have a baby, that's the right way to do it, you know? We don't think about mistakes and stuff like that. We talk about the real thing. It's made of love, you know? So you were born in love, not with an ego. But our parents have ego when they made us. But you see, it's not our choice, it's not the choice of us that we were born with an ego. It's not a part of us, you know? It's like it was implanted to us. And the thing is that we need to detach ourselves from it. And that's paradigm zero. That's my theory. That's beyond science. That's Shikikili style knowledge. Inside, call it all you want it, but it come from here. And look where I am. In a temple. So listen to me, and it will bring lots of good into your life. I promise that. But we need to, not only you, but me too, I need to start not paying attention to all these tests. Like, I'm gonna give you another example. My father is an alcoholic, and everybody knows that. Okay, if you don't know that, now you know. And I was living all by myself, and life bring me back to my parents at 32 years old, with my father alcoholic and my mother. And I realized that when I pay attention to him, it gets worse. Because we are two worlds apart, you know. I'm the best cleaner in the world. I achieved my dream. You know, I don't want to do comparison, but it's the reality. It's the fact that I take care of my health. I train my body. I'm active. I do everything I can to be a better person. And I don't need that. Me, my life is good. I built my dream of beauty, of beautiful thing, of beautiful knowledge. I don't need to see that always in my face. And at the beginning, I was forcing myself to say, hi, how are you? But it led to nothing. So it's a waste of energy for me to do that. I think it's better. Somebody told me that light, when you try to help, not help someone, but you try to be nice to someone, you know, not because it's hard, because they are really dark, you know. When you are light and they are dark, they're gonna see your light and it's gonna be worse. It's gonna do the reverse effect. So that's bad. That's really bad. For real. So the best thing to do is to not pay attention to it. And that's what she said to me. And she is amazing. She's a true angel. And she has over 40 years of meditation every day. Yeah. So it makes sense now. I realize this, and this is good for everybody. Everybody who has darkness, that you can feel it, you can see it, it's not good. Stop paying attention to it. It's not gonna be easy, but you need to do it. You need to find a way. Focus on how you're gonna make it. And the solution will pop up into your life. There is no choice, because pray for it, yeah. Because your heart always wants the best for you. Your heart wants you to stay in love, in harmony, in joy, in happiness. So you're true to yourself, you admit that this happened to your life. Okay, so now what? What should I do? Please, give me the solution. Because it's not healthy for me, and it's time for change. And I'm ready for change. That's what we should tell ourselves when we live these kind of tests, these negative ego tests from the old world, because it's not a part of the new world. Tribe City is 100% made of love only. Only love can live. And when you are in love, magic and miracle happen. So that's what I have to say about that. And it's time for me to continue the process of cleaning without thinking about how dirty it is. So the best thing to do is to think about spirituality. That's it. That's it. What more can I say? Okay, this part is a bonus. I was working on this video and somebody knocked on my door. Do you want to play cards? Okay. So of course it's a test. It's a test. So I say okay, but I'm going into the test. I go explore what take place. But keep in mind that my father is an alcoholic and my mother, she drink one beer, and we are at that time of day that she drink a beer. So I'm there at the table with them and we play cards. And all along I focus on the game. I detach myself from that they are my parents and my father is alcoholic and my mother, she allow it to be in her life. So I detach myself from it. And everything it's good, okay? Even if I lose two games and my mother win. My mother, I have lots of love for her. She's a really strong woman. And she probably do her mission of life to do this for him and for me too, because she's strong. She's been through a whole lot in her life. So at the end of the second game, something changed. She shift. My mother shift. Because first of all, I say, okay, two game is enough. So I respect myself. But they convince me, or I convince myself, I don't know, it was weird. But I accept to play another game. And it was hard, for real, for me to stay in my heart space. I can feel the tension. So, but I keep my light, I don't give up. And at the end I win. Why I win? It's because I have the will to stay in my heart. So whatever you go through into your life, because we live in a time that everything go more fast, everything is shifting. We are in a time that everything is fast, but us, we need to slow down and we need to go back where truly matter inside of us. And when we do that, we allow the experience to be positive, to have a positive result for everybody. But to be able to do that, we need to stay focused on us. And it's a hard thing to do, because there is so many different kind of people that going through so many energy stuff right now, that we need to detach ourselves from who they are. Detach yourself from the part that they play and focus on the lesson that we can learn from this experience. Since I was doing this video talking about fuel the bad, this experience, I need to live it to be able to share it at the end of this video. That I don't participate in too bad. I go there, shining my light by being present and focus on the lesson that I'm gonna learn from this. By staying in my heart and the experience of me, my mother and my father, detach myself from that I am the son and they are my parents, to just play a game of cards. Fun. You see, the goal was fun. And to have fun with these difference that we have between us three. We need to detach ourselves and see beyond all of this. And beyond all of this, it's by staying into your heart, you allow others to do the same. Because this is so powerful. With 40,000 cells, you are in business. And at the end, it's fun that will win. Peace. And that's the purpose of life. It's doing what you love. And when you do what you love, you have fun. Fun is contagious. Fun is magic. Fun creates miracles. Life lesson. See, look behind me. We live in a yin-yang world. The blue and the red. Oh yes. But one thing for sure, we are not yin-yang. But we live in the world of yin-yang. Don't make mistake about it.